The city of LA is working to remove homeless camps along the Venice boardwalk. Crews from the sanitation department worked overnight Thursday into Friday morning to remove tents and debris. People living in the camps are typically given a 24-hour notice so they have a chance to leave on their own. If not, they're evicted and their items are removed. The council in Mike Barnes has extended the warning by a week to not clear, and the cleanup will be done. A restaurant has been issued for this evening in an effort to ease some of the strain on the power system during the heat wave. The California Independent System Operator says the flex alert will be in effect between 4 and 9 p.m. During that time, people are encouraged to power down major appliances and set their thermostats to 78 degrees or higher. The National Weather Service is predicting high temperatures over 100 for most of California. Kaiser Permanente Dr. David Benson says everyone needs to take precautions in the heat.
Wearing light, loose-fitting clothing, avoid strenuous activities, drinking plenty of fluids, and staying cool.
Going to be many cooling centers open this weekend. A flex alert has been extended into today. That alert is active from 4 to 9 tonight. A Confederate monument that helped spark a violent white supremacist rally is coming down. Charlottesville, Virginia, officials say the statue of General Robert E. Lee on a horse, along with the statue of the Confederate General Stonewall Jackson, will both be removed today. The first further removal of the statue of Lee in 2016 led up to the Unite the Right rally in 2017 that turned violent and protesters and crowd protesters clashed. Surfs up at Lake Tahoe.
Seismologists say the 6.0 earthquake that hit near the California-Nevada border Thursday generated big roller waves on nearby Lake Tahoe. Witnesses say the waves were big enough they would have worked for just about any surfer. Seismologists say they expect the area to be rocked by aftershocks for several days, and that could generate more roller waves on the lake. By yesterday, more than 60 aftershocks had rumbled through the area in the eastern Sierra Nevada. Amy King, KFI News.
Let's check in on some traffic trouble. Let's go straight. We're going to take you through your weather coming up next. Get ready for a heat wave.
When it comes to your identity and keeping it safe, the folks at LifeLock want to make sure that your information stays secure. So let's say during the pandemic, or even now, you're working overtime, you're saving your money, you're paying off your debt, and now some identity thief wants to steal your information. This is why LifeLock by Norton helps monitor your information and alerts you to potential identity threats. And if you do become a victim, a dedicated U.S.-based specialist will be there to help fix it. Now, no one can prevent all identity theft or monitor every transaction, every business. But when identity thieves try to take what's yours, you don't have to take it lying down, because there's LifeLock. Save up to 25% off your first year. Call 800-LIFELOCK or go to LifeLock.com, promo code HANDLE. That's LifeLock.com, promo code HANDLE, or call 800-LIFELOCK, promo code HANDLE. Once again, that's promo code HANDLE for 25% off at LifeLock.com.
Southland weather from KFI. Sunshine for today. Highs from the low to mid-70s. At the beaches to mid to upper 80s inland. Highs in the 80s and 90s for the valleys. Highs in the upper 70s to 60s for the inland OC. And highs in the mid-90s to 103 in the IE. Taking through temperatures that we are seeing in the Southland. In Anaheim at 69, Laguna Beach 65, Diamond Bar 68, and Cerritos 68. We leave local live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Claudette Stefania.
Whisperer, custom home builder, custom home designer, here live with you like I always am every Saturday morning from 6 to 8 and Sundays from 9 to 11. here to be an advocate for you as you wrestle with the construction issues on your home. A design mentor. Why? Because design matters most when it comes to transforming your home. And, you know, a friendly voice as you take on the noble work of turning your ordinary house into something extraordinary. The team is... where did that come from? The team is here. Misty, our producer, is standing by, holding us all together. She's also ready to take your calls. Tyler is on the board this morning. Good morning, Tyler.
Hey, good morning.
And a huge personality in a tiny package, Claudette Stefanian, is on the news desk. Good morning, Claudette.
Hi, good morning. Are you guys up yet?
We're here.
There you go.
There it is. All right, and Tina, my better half, and it's Tina plus one this morning. Oh, I got to get a picture of this. Wait a second. Oh, now he's laying down. We have been joined this morning. You can't see this, but you will. We'll put it by Sammy the Beagle. There it is, right there. Okay, here, throw that up on wherever that thing is. The interweb. You got to take a look at Sammy the Beagle, who has co-opted Tina's seat in the studio completely. All right. Well, how many times do people start conversations this week with, it's a warm one? It just is. It's a warm, lovely summer day. And what do you expect for July in Southern California? It's simply the way it is. I tell you where we're going today with our time together. There are questions that, you know, as you know, you call in and ask me regularly, but there are some questions that just keep coming back again and again, common questions, and Tina and I assembled a list of them this week, of ones that we deal with quite regularly, repeatedly, and we thought, you know what, that's a category of information all unto itself. So, we have a list of common listener questions, some of the most common and most important ones. And Tina's just going to kind of pick and choose and rapid fire them off at me, and I'm going to do my best not to screw it all up. How's that sound?
Sounds good. Okay. Sounds right.
All right. Sounds right that I should avoid screwing it up?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So why don't we just dive in? Throw one at me and Sam, are you ready?
Ready for this?
Oh my God. All right.
Okay. How do I know if I found a good contractor?
I think
that is probably one of the questions we get the most.
Well, thanks for starting with an easy one.
Yeah.
How do you know that you have found a good contractor? Well, okay, so here's how I'm not going to answer this. I'm not going to go into every aspect of what we do to vet a good contractor. But the basic, most fundamental answer to that question is, you know you have found a good contractor because you have done your due diligence in vetting a contractor. Vetting a contractor means that not only have you found them by way of a halfway decent referral, maybe a friend has referred them, maybe one of your neighbors who's been doing remodel work that has looked good to you has referred them. Maybe you found them on a home building service or home improvement service like House or, you know, one of those things. We actually really strongly recommend House because it's a venue. Tell me if I'm wrong with this, Tina. Unlike Angie's List and some of those other things, Houses has been... kind of infected with self-promotion by builders in those categories. So they really are still kind of a pure referral list. But the point is this. When you are looking for a contractor and you compile some referrals, of course, we always say look for three or more in any category that you're working so that you can get three or more estimates, compare estimates, and figure out, you know, who's got what, and look for the outliers so that you know you've got three minds looking at your problem. But as far as settling in on one of those three, when you're feeling strongly about a particular one, you've got to check references. And those references need to be, I cannot emphasize this enough, the references need to be current references. All of, you know, here's the thing about the building trade. Once we've built something, it stands for a long time. And, you know, there are a lot of us who are very proud of certain projects. There are projects that I'm very proud of that I did 30 years ago, okay? I don't refer people ever to clients from 30 years ago, projects from 30 years ago, because it's not a reflection on what's happening right now. It's not a reflection of the state of the union as it is right now. That's what we want to find out. You know, most contracting businesses that work on residential homes are small businesses. Small businesses are fantastic, but they're also subject to, you know, kind of small business life circumstances. Sometimes just the builder or the contractor may be going through a rough patch, maybe going through some personal family. You just never know. So you want recent references. I want to know the projects that they're working on right now. I want to talk to their clients that just finished up 3 months ago and not much further in the past than that. So that's how you know. You've got somebody, you've vetted them, you've talked with their previous clients who they're just either working on currently or have just finished, recent references, and so you have that confidence that right now, not only is this a good builder, but currently, all of their ducks are in a row. And there you go. All right, you got more on that list. I've got more answers to come. And we will do this when we return. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. So much more to come. You're listening to Home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Claudette Stefania has the news.
At least one person has been hurt during a drive-by shooting outside Knott's Berry Farm in Buena Park. The shooting happened around 8:40 last night. A flex alert has been issued for tonight in an effort to ease some of the strain on the power grid during the heat wave. The California Independent System Operator says the flex alert will be in effect from 4 to 9 p.m. A new report says traffic in L.A. has jumped up 8% following the peak of the pandemic. Researchers from INRIC found during the peak of the pandemic, L.A. had two of the nation's worst traffic corridors. We check in on the 10 next.
So, I heard you're ready to build your new dream kitchen, finally. That is fantastic. What is your first move? It should be this. A totally free in-showroom consult at the kitchen store. That means you get two things right out of the gate. You're going to get the creativity and the wisdom of an expert kitchen designer. And what do I say? Design matters most. And when it comes to your kitchen, it is doubly true. And you're going to get that creativity and wisdom while you're being flooded with inspiration inside the kitchen store's 7,000 square foot cabinet design showroom. The kitchen store is right off the 405 in Culver City. And for more than 50 years, it has been the place for kitchen cabinets in all of Southern California. They have state-of-the-art computer design, 12-month same as cash financing, pricing that beats the big box home center. So why go anywhere else? There's no reason to. Start your new kitchen right. Set up your free consult today by dialing the kitchen store at 310-KITCHEN. That's 310-KITCHEN. And check them out on the web at 310kitchen.com.
Southland weather from KFI. Sunshine for today. Highs from the low to mid-70s. At the beaches to mid to upper 80s inland. Highs in the 80s and 90s for the valleys. Highs in the upper 70s to 60s for the inland OC. And highs in the mid-90s to 103 in the IE. Let's check in on some trouble on the 10.
West Covina on the westbound side of the 10. Veronica to Vincent. It's the carpool and two left lanes have been shut down by Caltrans. They should be in the process of wrapping up this closure in the next little while, but Dorsey's headed away through the area. All lanes shut down in Stillmore on the westbound side of the 210. Hubbard to the 5. Caltrans worked here all weekend long. From Monday morning around 5 o'clock, you use Foothill Boulevard instead. And in Elysian Park on the 110 north, the transition to the 5 north shut down to around 9 o'clock this morning. KFI in the sky helps get there faster. I'm Robert Kabucky.
I'm Mike Huckabee, former governor of Arkansas and 2016 presidential candidate. Like many of you, I've struggled to get a good night's sleep until about 2 years ago. That's when I saw an ad on TV for Relaxium Sleep, and it literally changed my life. Developed by renowned neurologist Dr. Eric Silberti, Relaxium Sleep is clinically proven to help you fall asleep, stay asleep, and wake up refreshed. Relaxium's triple action formula addresses three key factors that contribute to insomnia. With Relaxium Sleep, I fall asleep as soon as my head hits the pillow. I find I've got more energy and focus. I trust my night to Relaxium Sleep, and so should you. Get the sleep you need with Relaxium, so you can live your life to the fullest. Your best sleep guaranteed or your money back. Call 800-999-6410 or go to Relaxium.com. Use promo code Mike and save 50%. Call 800-999-6410 or go to Relaxium.com. This report is sponsored by America's Best Contacts and Eyeglasses.
Don't overpaper glasses. Get two pairs and a free exam for just $69.95. The exam alone is worth $50. That's not just a better deal. It's America's Best. Book your exam online today.
In certain states, eye exams provided by independent optometrists or ophthalmologists. See store for details.
Are you planning to sell your home? Really, really important question. Why? Because if you are, it's time to start thinking about getting the biggest possible return on your investment, which means it's time to talk to Revive. You've seen shows that take a home like yours, upgrade it, flip it for a big return. That's Revive, except Revive does it for you. Your home is going to net way more profit with the right upgrades. We all know this. You just don't know what those are, but Revive does. They know exactly how to make the most of what you've got and even create value where there isn't. And the coolest thing about this whole thing is that Revive manages everything and fronts all of the costs. Yeah, Revive fronts the cost. They get paid back from escrow, but the profit gained is all yours. The average client makes over 200% profit on what Revive invests on their behalf. It is a no-brainer. So if you are ready to sell your home, go to iloverevive.com today and see if your home qualifies. To make the most from the sale of your home, why wouldn't you? Go to iloverevive.com. That's iloverevive.com.
Hi, we're the Goo Goo Dolls. We're fortunate that we can give our daughters everything they need to grow and learn, but not every child can focus on classes and play dates.
Nearly 13 million kids in the U.S. face hunger. That's 1 in 6. School lunch might be their only meal each day, but it's heartbreaking to imagine any child going to bed hungry. We're dreaming of a perfect day when kids can smile, play, and just be kids without worrying about where their next meal will come from. Feeding America is working to make that perfect day a reality.
Each year, the Feeding America network of food banks rescues billions of pounds of good food that would have gone to waste. That food is given to families and children in need. Being a kid should be about doing things that make an ordinary day extraordinary. Learning to play an instrument, building a sandcastle, hosting tea parties. Hunger should never be an obstacle to growing up.
You can help end childhood hunger in your community by visiting feedingamerica.org.
Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Now may be the perfect time to buy a home financed by Loan Depot. Loan Depot has over 300 loan products to help you make home ownership a reality. Interest rates are near historic lows. Rates will not stay low forever. So call 866-888-LOAN so one of our thousands of loan officers can help you find the right loan. Call 866-888-LOAN or visit LoanDepot.com. Loan Depot. Rates are subject to change. Equal housing opportunity lender. NMLS number 174457. Licensed in all 50 states.
Did you ever notice how everyone seems to look down on plumbers? Maybe because it's a dirty job, or the whole plumber's crap stereotype. I don't really know, but I know it's not fair. This is Leland Smith, founder and CEO of Service Champions, and I want to take a moment on this commercial to talk specifically to the Service Champions team of professional plumbers. I want you to know how proud I am of you, individually and as a group. You put all those plumber stereotypes to rest by showing up to work with a great attitude and work ethic. You're punctual, you're friendly, you're courteous, and you're clean. You treat our customers with respect and you get the job done right the first time. Being a plumber is a thankless job, so I want to thank you for making Service Champions the best plumbing company in the state. We clear grants for just $88. Or for any other plumbing problem, call Service Champions toll-free at 833-777-7777 or online at servicechampions.com.
For official rules and more information about contests on this station, go to KFIAM640.com/rules. KFIAM640. More stimulating talk.
Whisper, you are listening to Home, where every week we help you better understand that place where you live. Hey, I am spending the morning getting asked questions by my bud here, Tina, who has compiled a list of commonly asked listener questions, the kind that just keep coming up again and again, and so they're important enough to make it onto that list. But also, I want to talk to you about whatever your question is today, whatever it may be, anything you want to ask me regarding your home, whether it be
a design question. Okay,
right? It's impressive. So whether it's a design question or a construction issue or a DIY, you know, whatever it may be, the number to reach me is 833-2-ASK-DEAN, 833-2-ASK-DEAN, and we'll be going to the phones should we have any of such questions available to us in just a few minutes. So, until then, the phone lines are open now, so give us a call, jump into the queue, and who knows, maybe you and I can talk, and we can talk about your home. All right, babe, what's up? What's the next one? Wait. Get the mic away from Sammy the Beagle. Are we the only hosts on KFI that have live animals in studio on a weekly basis?
Could be. Awesome.
Oh, no, don't worry. There are others. Don't you worry.
Okay.
Maybe the people are the animals.
Oh, hi. Okay. Read the question.
So, one of the questions that we seem to get a lot have to do with LED lighting.
Yes.
So we have two different questions. We'll start with, why do my new LED bulbs flicker when I try to dim them?
That's an easy one.
It's an easy one, and then we'll move into the second LED question.
Your new LED bulbs flicker when you try to dim them because, unfortunately, you bought the wrong kind of LED bulb. LED is it's light emitting diode. It is a completely different technology than the old incandescent bulbs. Any incandescent bulb, or halogen bulb for that matter, operates on the same principle as current moves through the filament in a vacuum that's created inside the bulb. That current, the filament lights up, it causes it to glow. In its environment. So the less current that runs through it, the less it glows, the more current, the more it glows, which means that any incandescent bulb works beautifully on a dimmer because you just give it less power and it doesn't emit as much light. But LEDs are a completely different animal. They have to be built for dimming or they're not. And that is why when you're buying an LED bulb, it needs to say on the package, dimmable. If you don't buy a dimmable LED, it is designed to just be thrown on off, 100% zero, nothing in between. And if you try and dim it, you get the flashing, the flashing light. So there you go.
Okay. This one has to do with the LED bulb terms. Well, some things like 3,000K, 80 watts, equivalent, 500 lumens. 90 CRI, so...
Right. So if you're an old schooler, if you're an old school light bulb person, which everybody is, who's older than 25 or so, then here's the thing. You have been trained up in a world, you've been trained up improperly. it's just the way you've been trained up in a world where we make equivalent the wattage of a bulb with the brightness of the bulb. Because, like I just said, on an incandescent light, those two things have a relationship to each other. So, for instance, if I was going to say to you in old world terms, like, oh, we need a pretty bright bulb in here, you might suggest to me, oh, maybe we should put a 100-watt bulb in that light instead of a 60-watt bulb. Okay, so understand, wattage has nothing to do with the brightness of the bulb. Wattage is a measurement of how much energy the bulb consumes. Okay, but again, with an incandescent bulb, the amount of energy it consumes and the amount of light it puts off is a relationship, and that's how it works. We always, let me be very clear, we always, if you're going to do good lighting design in your house, you always needed to get away from that, always. Because the amount of light output from any given bulb is not measured in watts, it's measured in lumens. Lumens is how bright a bulb is. And just to give you an idea, scale, you can find scales on the interweb, but basically, a 100-watt light bulb throws off about 800 lumens. So that's the number we're looking for, okay? 800 lumens, 300 lumens, 200 lumens. We get used to that, and you will understand how to buy new LED bulbs. In addition, there's this little helpful guide. It confuses people, but it's there to help. It's on the side of an LED bulb, you'll find it says 80 watt equivalent, okay? That's them trying to tell you, I know you're talking old language, so remember how you would get an 80 watt bulb? Well, this, as far as brightness goes, is an 80 watt equivalent. They say 80 watt equivalent because that bulb doesn't consume 80 watts. It probably consumes 3 watts, okay? But the brightness is 80 watt equivalent, all right? There are two other factors, but we need to talk about that when we come back. There's the color temperature of the light. Again, something that can vary with LED that doesn't vary with incandescent. And then there is what is called the CRI rating of the light. We'll talk about that when we return, as well as go to the phones and take your calls. You're home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Your call's up next. Well, that's Stefania has the news.
Has jumped up 8% following the peak of the pandemic. Researchers from INRIC found during the peak of the pandemic, LA had two of the nation's worst traffic corridors. It also shows there were 21% fewer collisions and 20% fewer miles driven. The earthquake near Mammoth Lake has revealed some quirks in the shake alert system. USGS Earthquake Early Warning Coordinator Doug Given says the initial reports on Thursday's quake actually indicated 3 earthquakes, when there was only one.
But we're finding with this state of Eastern California earthquakes we're experiencing lately that they're happening in an area of the state where we haven't completed the station build-out yet, and that's hurting us.
Given says shake alert is getting better, and each notable earthquake offers more information for how to better tweak the system. Search crews in Florida have found the bodies of 79 people at the site of a collapsed condo building in Surfside. Miami-Dade County Fire Chief Alan Kominski says the recovery crews are making progress sifting through the rubble, but there's no timeline for when they'll be finished.
We had, numbers of the unfortunate numbers of the victims, and that's what we're here for, not only the searches, but the searches in every area that we have.
Crews are still looking for 61 missing people. Giant pandas are no longer classified as an endangered species. The Chinese Ministry of Ecology and Environment says the number of giant pandas living in the wild has reached more than 1,800, so the species has been reclassified as a vulnerable population. Animal experts say Chinese breeding programs and protections for panda habitats in the wild have been important in saving the animals. Let's check in on traffic trouble on the 210.
Still more on the westbound side of the 210 freeway. Hubbard to the 5 Caltrans had all lanes shut down all weekend long. So around 5 o'clock Monday morning, you can take Foothill Boulevard instead. In West Covina, late running project on the westbound side of the 10. Barranca to Vincent is the carpool lane. 2 left lanes shut down. Really stop and go through that stretch. And the eastbound side of the 10 is Citrus Port to the new crash there in the middle lane. Watch out for the sudden delay. Montebello, eastbound side of the 60, Fidelity to Rosemead Boulevard. 3 left lanes that are coned off at around 8 o'clock this morning. Say a fire in the sky, help get there faster. I'm Bucky.
So,
I've been trying to describe what life is like with a whole house water filtration system from Life Source Water, and it's a little tough. And the reason it's a little tough is because the best description is normal. Life feels normal. In other words, you know how you always dreamed water and your house, the relationship that they would have to each other, that when you're thirsty, you just go to a faucet and turn it on and put the glass underneath, and out comes cool, delicious, clean drinking water. Well, that's what happens with a Life Source system. Every single faucet in the entire house, the tub spout, the shower head, all the faucets, even the toilet. That's not really necessary, but maybe for your dog. The point is this. Life Source treats all the water in your entire home so that it is clean and delicious, and you don't have to go to the store in the 21st century to buy bottled water in plastic. When you're thirsty, just turn on the faucet. There's no filters to replace. There's no maintenance of any kind. It helps with hard water problems, reduces the odor and taste of chlorine, and also is easy. Still ongoing Life Source 4th of July sale, which means right now, Life Source will pay your sales tax. So you get huge savings while they transform all the water in your home into what you always hoped it would be. So call Life Source today, 800-334-5009, 800-334-5009, or visit LifeSourceWater.com. Life Source Water, taste, feel the difference.
Southland weather from KFI. Sunshine for today. Highs from the low to mid-70s at the beaches to mid to upper 80s inland. Highs in the 80s and 90s for the valleys. Highs in the upper 70s to 60s for the inland OC, and highs in the mid-90s to 103 in the IE. We leave local live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Claudette Stefanian.
I'm Mike Huckabee, former governor of Arkansas and 2016 presidential candidate. Like many of you, I've struggled to get a good night's sleep until about 2 years ago. That's when I saw an ad on TV for Relaxium Sleep, and it literally changed my life. Developed by renowned neurologist Dr. Eric Siliberti, Relaxium Sleep is clinically proven to help you fall asleep, stay asleep, and wake up refreshed. Relaxium's triple action formula addresses three key factors that contribute to insomnia. With Relaxium Sleep, I fall asleep as soon as my head hits the pillow. I find I've got more energy and focus. I trust my night to Relaxium Sleep, and so should you. Get the sleep you need with Relaxium so you can live your life to the fullest. Your best sleep guaranteed or your money back. Call 800-999-6410 or go to Relaxium.com. Use promo code Mike and save 50%. Call 800-999-6410 or go to Relaxium.com.
I know you've seen all those great home loans being advertised, but you're probably not sure if you qualify. Or maybe you've been told, nope, you can't get that low rate. Well, I bet you haven't called IntelliLoan. Right now, IntelliLoan has a 1.99% rate in APR with no points or lender fees for SoCal residents. And this is even if your credit score is as low as 620. It's a 1.99% rate in APR with no points and no lender fees. And you've heard me talk about Daryl, the owner of IntelliLoan. He's got a team of home loan specialists that really want to make this home loan process not suck. They want to make it as hassle-free as possible for you. So call IntelliLoan today at 1-800-918-6200. That's 1-800-918-6200, or just go to IntelliLoan.com.
Rates subject to change without notice. Minimum loan amount requirements apply. 50% loan to value and 620 FICO credit score. Certain restrictions apply. Subject to credit approval. NMLS 3290. Loans made or arranged pursuant to a California Finance Lender's Law License number 603-6970. Equal housing lender. IntelliLoan. Borrow smart.
KFI. Live and local.
Our radio station.
AM 640 and live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. You're home. It's Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Hey, thanks for joining the program this morning. We are about to go to the phones and take a call or two. But before then, I think we had some leftover. We're in the middle of a conversation wrapped all around common listener questions. Tina has assembled a list of the kinds of questions that we get asked again and 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 again.
And so if it's that kind of a question, it's made it onto Tina's list. And so where were we? We're in the middle of something.
As we were talking about, now I've got that thing.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. The way that we just determine the color of LED.
Oh, LED lights. That's right. Okay. So the two things that that I didn't get to in regards to LED lights, the new terminology, which, just to underscore again, is the way we should always have done it. So please, if you're one of those people like, why can't we just go back to the whole... In my head, that's what someone like that sounds like, okay. No matter what, even if they're a small child. So the point is this, please, don't be grumpy about this. This is what we should have learned from day one, as far as if you evaluate light, the brightness of light based on its lumen, not its wattage, its lumen, okay? We also evaluate light on whether they're dimmable or not. We also evaluate lights on, here we go, color temperature and a little thing called CRI, or the color rendering index. Okay, color temperature is very simply this. White light is not white light. It is a spectrum of color temperature, not heat temperature. Color temperature is measured in degrees Kelvin. Okay, so what do you need to know? For inside a house, you are rarely ever going to reach for a bulb that has a color temperature higher than 3,000K. 3,000K is kind of, in for an interior of a house, kind of bright white. Now, is it ultimate bright white? No, it's not. Daylight is more like 5,000K, okay? But bring that inside the house, and it's going to look blue. You're going to look blue and cold and weird, and nobody likes 5,000K bulbs inside a home. In a home where we're used to incandescent lighting to begin with, and beautiful incandescent, we're in the 2,800K department, right? So if you can get just below 3,000, that's optimal. Just so you know, 1,800 Kelvin, 1,800K, is the color temperature of open flame, candlelight. So it's very amber. You know, most of those vintage bulbs that kind of glow really yellow and amber, those are about 1,800 K. So a normal interior home light for the kind of light that you're looking for, a little bit of warmth to it and a lot of brightness, 2,700
by the apartment.
The only other thing there is the color rendering index. This is sometimes more important than in other situations.